Let us please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
In holy baptism, Mildred was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all her sin. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?"
We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his.
Please remain standing.
Consider all the works thy hand has.
Praise is due to you, O God in Zion, and to you shall vows be performed.
O you who hears prayers, to you shall all flesh come.
When iniquities prevail against me, you atone for our transgressions.
Blessed is the one who chooses to bring me near, to dwell in your courts. He shall be satisfied with the goodness of your house, the holiness of your temple.
By awesome deeds you answer us with righteousness, O God of our salvation, the hope of all the ends of the earth and of the farthest seas. Who stills the roaring of the waves, the roaring of their waves, the tumult of the peoples.
So that those who dwell at the ends of the earth are in awe at your signs. You make the going out of the morning and the evening to shout for joy.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Millie and to all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. The Old Testament reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
I lift up my eyes to the hills.
Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber.
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The epistle reading from 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Now I would remind you, brothers, of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, in which you stand, and by which you are being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unworthy to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we preach, and so you believed. Now, if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? But if there is no resurrection of the dead, then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is in vain, and your faith is in vain. We are even found to be misrepresenting God, because we testified about God that he raised Jesus, whom he did not raise, if it is true that the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. And then those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If in this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people to be most pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ shall all be made alive, but each in his own order. Christ the firstfruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he delivers the kingdom to God the Father after destroying every rule and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be defeated is death. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus Christ is the firstborn of the dead.
To him be glory and power forever. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 5th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life. He does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life. Truly, truly, I say to you, an hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day,
please be seated as we sing together the next hymn, Just As I Am, Without One Plea.
Thank you.
Text selected from 1 Corinthians. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. The words of our text. To you, Mildred's daughters, to family, friends, grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. At a time such as this, it is very important, I think, for us to remember who a person was. It's important to do that because you wouldn't think it, but it's so easy to forget. I mean, it took me a bit of sitting and thinking and remembering to remember your mother and father's house over on Northgate. And I drive by it every day. And I forgot, you know, that they lived over there. It was filled with the teapot collection and filled with Millie's crafts. I don't even know. I mean, honestly, I can't even remember if Mira and Levi were even born yet when Grandma and Grandpa lived in the house. Maybe Mira was, but if she was, she was super tiny. Probably not something you even remember. And her youngest great-grandchild? Not even a memory for her, will it be, the great-grandma's house over there, her old house. Those memories are for kids and grandkids. I mean, don't get me wrong. There's plenty of memories that you as daughters have. Memories of life with your mom and dad are, I'm sure, far different than the memories your children have of their grandma and their grandpa. You girls can remember places like Cotton's Corner over in Atlanta and the stores that your mom and your dad ran, the grocery stores that they ran and operated. And then there was Millie's love of auctions and garage sales, where who knows what treasures she would find, or collectibles, or a crafting item. Then there are some of the things that pretty much the whole family shares in common. So many of you have commented that you remember her cooking, her fried chicken, and the pies that she had made. And Mira, I know you have fond memories of waiting for Christmas to come around so that you could go and make sugar cookies with great-grandma. And speaking of shared memories, just wasn't too long ago where Julie told me one of the favorite ones that she has. And it was one of Millie's favorite stories, apparently. It was the time when Dad didn't come home straight from work, but he stopped off at the pool hall on the way home. Now, I don't know what your dad said, but my dad always said, if we had more pool halls in the world, we'd need fewer schools. But I don't know if I should believe what my father said on that one. But you've got to understand, even though there were no cell phones and no Life 360 on the iPhone and all of that, yeah, Dad could have probably picked up the phone and said, hey, hon, I stopped off a little early. I'm going to be running late for supper, but Millie had supper ready, and he wasn't home, and he didn't come home. And finally got home, I guess she was just a little bit hot under the collar. And she decided that her husband, Don, would take her to the mall and that she would go shopping. And he took her to the mall, and she did go shopping. And she came out, apparently, with two outfits and said, which one do you like? Which one should I get? And Don gave the absolute right answer. He said, both. And that was the right answer. Now, I have to admit, right now, it's a bit difficult thinking of Millie going to the Oasis to play Bunko and Pinochle, and I can't even see Millie as the young woman who in 1968 taught herself to drive so that she could go downtown. And I didn't even know that you used to get your driver's license at the Colgrove instead of at the DMV. But apparently she drove downtown to get her driver's license, got her driver's license, and it took longer than what she thought. And apparently she came out and the meter had expired. And she had a parking ticket. So she got her parking ticket and her driver's license all on the same day. And she apparently turned right around, went back in the courthouse with the parking ticket, paid the parking ticket. That's what she did. And that's the self-confident Millie that she was, to teach herself to drive, to not get flustered at some of those things like that. But sadly, over the years, especially over the last decade, that confidence ebbed, and the Millie we knew became a different Millie, another mom, another grandma. Because over the last decade, the anxiety began to take over, and it was filled with trips to the ER and phantom pains and food that never tasted good. And an anxious heart and an anxious mind co-opted her thoughts. But that's not who she was in total. Mildred continued hearing the word of her Savior in worship. She continued receiving the body and blood of Christ in the sacrament of the altar for the forgiveness of her sins, the strengthening of her faith. And her Savior held fast to her. And in such a grasp as Christ, Millie passed from who she was through who she became to who she is. And who she is expressed in a poem she kept in her Bible at home, a poem written by a former lay minister here at Zion, a poem by Mr. Hans Haywish. And the last stanza goes like this. Grandma keeps waiting week after week. While reading her Bible, she hears the Lord speak. I'm coming, Grandma. Just don't you doubt. There'll be no problems for others to worry about. An angel will carry you to heaven above, where you will be showered with heavenly love. Mildred Cotton is a baptized child of her Heavenly Father, a child redeemed by Jesus Christ, and as such, she now is more glorious than any of us can even begin to imagine. And Millie received the summons of God Almighty, God who sent his angels to bring her soul to heaven. She is covered in Christ's forgiveness, Christ's holiness, Christ's righteousness, and she has been ushered into the throne room of God. As St. John says, and behold, I looked, and there was a vast multitude that no one could count around the throne and around the Lamb, and they were praising God day and night in his temple. Millie has passed from this life to the life that is to come. She has passed from weakness to strength, from earthbound to glory, from mortal to immortal. She has that which we all long for. As the hymn writer states, come, O Christ, and loose the chains that bind us. Lead us forth and cast this world behind us. With you, the anointed finds the soul, its joy and rest appointed. We have moved from who Millie was to who she became and to who she now is. And there is one chapter left, who she will be. Because the soul going to heaven, that's not the end. That's not where we stop at all. There is still that which we and the holy angels look forward to and all the saints in heaven long for. And that is that last great day of resurrection. The day when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ returns in all of his glory and majesty. And the dead in Christ will rise first. And then we who are left shall join them and be caught up in the air with them. And therefore we shall always be with Christ. As the body of Christ, the church on earth, as all God's saints in heaven look forward, they grab hold of what St. Paul writes for us. Beloved, we are God's children now. And what we shall be has not yet appeared, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Mildred, and all of us who trust in Christ for redemption and for forgiveness, shall rise from the grave with new, glorified, and everlasting bodies, strong bodies, glorious as God intended us to be, reflecting the radiance of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And on that last great day, we shall be reunited with those who have died in the faith before us, and we shall live forever. And in that confidence of who we will be on that day, God's people say, Amen. And now may that peace which passes all understanding be in your hearts and minds through the one true faith in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Let us now all rise for prayer. Let us pray to the Lord our God and Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion, into the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been nourished by the holy body and blood of your Son may be raised to immortality and incorruption, to be seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, give to the family of Millie and to all who mourn comfort in their grief, and a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church, they may have the strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy, help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe in and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, receive our thanks for Millie and for all the blessings you bestowed upon her in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with her we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord in trusting his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die.
Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory
be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and grant thee his peace.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord. Amen.
We remain standing for our closing hymn.